MSF has decided to evacuate its staff from six hospitals in the north of Yemen due to the recent incident that we have suffered in Abs city in our hospital that caused the death of 19 people, among them patients and one MSF staff member. It's also due to the fact that the ongoing air campaign is still very, very intense, and we consider that, the place is not safe enough. On top of that, so the explanations given by the Saudi-led coalition are not enough reassuring for us. We don't think that all measures necessary are being taken to prevent more incidents. So we have the feeling that this incident might happen again, and we consider therefore that hospitals are not safe neither for the patients nor for our staff. The decision of evacuating our staff is extremely difficult. It's one very, very difficult to make. We hope that this is going to be a temporary evacuation. We hope that we are going to be able to redeploy our teams as soon as possible. This will depend, of course, on the circumstances, on the working environment. If the ongoing air campaign decreases in intensity and we get some reassurances in the sense that this will not happen again, or at least that measures have been taken for that not to happen again, we will of course be willing to redeploy our teams as soon as possible. We understand that this is a critical situation right now, in this very moment for the populations, and we hope to be able to go back to those hospitals. We hope that the staff of the Minister of Health will continue to maintain open those hospitals. So we hope that at least essential services in those hospitals are going to be still available for the population. We are withdrawing with our medical staff. We are withdrawing pediatricians and intensive care specialized staff, staff that was able to reinforce the services and to help those hospitals to maintain an adequate level of care for the population. So we know, and this is very sad, that some of those services will decrease in their capacity to provide assistance. We fear particularly that most of the resources will be used and focused on treating war wounded, and so maternity services or pediatric services or chronic diseases are not going to be as well served as we were trying to ensure with our presence. But as I was saying, we hope that those hospitals will stay open. We hope that all the parties will keep them safe. So we hope that this will not happen again, and we hope that we are going to be able to go back. I want to insist on the fact that those hospitals will likely to continue to provide assistance to the patients and populations in those places. The situation is extremely severe now, and there are many, many needs in the field. We hope that all the parties that are involved in the conflict will respect those facilities, even without the presence of MSF. So we are actively calling for all the parties to avoid any targeting or any damage caused to those hospitals.